Hello guys, this is Ravens from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 110. Battlegrounds Mobile India Open beta version is now available. You can become a beta tester to try out the unreleased version of the game. Battlegrounds Mobile India was previously expected to release on June 18th. Grafton official website from Battlegrounds Mobile India includes a well-detailed support page for players looking to migrate their data to a new game. The important details that players can transfer are login information, basic information and the season rewards, achievement system, weapon skins, character systems and the vehicle systems. Swiggy might soon begin delivering food using unnamed drones in India. The food delivery service is set to begin trials for both food and medical packages along with its drone delivery partner Andhra Technologies. The registration for the Valorant Concurrence Championship tournament are now open. The tournament will also act as a qualifiers to the APAC Last Chance Qualifier. These qualifiers are a part of 2021 Valorant Champions Tour VCT. The VCT will offer a prize pool of around 25 lakhs Indian rupees. The registration for Valorant Concurrence Championship is currently live in India and will be open till June 28th. Matches for the same will be held between July 1st and July 11th. There will be a second round of registration will be happening between July 14th and 27th. The matches for those will be held between July 29th and August 2nd. Aside from India, VCC registration will also happen in Pakistan, Afghanistan, Nepal, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, Maldives and Bangladesh. Realme India and Europe CEO Madhav Seth recently confirmed that the company will be launching the Narzo 30 4G and 5G in India this month. And today the phone maker announced that Narzo 30 DO will debut in the Asian country next week on June 24th. Along with the Narzo 30 series, the company will also debut the upcoming Realme Buds Q2 and the Realme Smart TV 32 inches. Ahead of the launch, Realme India CMO Francis Wong has teased the upcoming Realme earbuds. Another interesting thing to note is the device the image was shot on. The image uploaded by Wong is shot on the Realme RMX 33XX, which is rumored to be the X9. According to the image, that shows that Buds Q2 kept near the Realme wireless neckband. The company has confirmed that true wireless earphones will be available for purchase via Amazon. Deezo, the first brand under Realme TechLife ecosystem, on Thursday partnered with homegrown e-commerce marketplace Flipkart to bring its product to consumer doorsteps. With this partnership, Deezo will make these four category of products, smart entertainment, smart home, smart care and smart accessories, available on Flipkart. Reliance Jio has continued to lead on 4G download speed with 20.7 Mbps average download speed recorded in May, while Vodafone Idea stood second in the 4G download speed with the same 6.3 Mbps average speed, while Airtel on the other hand recorded 4.7 Mbps on an average download speed. If we talk about the upload speed, the Mumbai-based operator faced the heat from Vodafone Idea that had 6.3 Mbps on an average 4G upload speed. It was also a way ahead from the 3.6 Mbps average speed that Airtel had it in the same month. Google announced its plan to open its first permanent brick and mortar store in New York City last month, and today Google unveiled the store. The store will open its door to the public on Wednesday, June 17th. In anticipation of its new store opening, Google offers a look inside the store, its layout and spaces throughout. Google today announced that the company will be expanding its COVID-19 relief efforts in India through its philanthropic arm Google.organization. The company pledged grants worth Rs. 113 crore to non-governmental organizations in the country, which will be used for upskilling workers, building oxygen generation plants and many more. Microsoft Corporation named Chief Executive Officer Satya Nadella as board chairman, strengthening his influence at the world's largest software maker after more than 7 years as a top executive. Nadella, who is 53 years old, succeeds John Thompson, who will return to the role of lead independent director, a position he held before being named as chairman in 2014. Amazon has confirmed that it has pulled out all the Rave Powers product from its stores. It comes days after a report that Rave Powers was offering gift cards in exchange of reviews. Similarly, it was happened to OK and M4 in May month. During Google I/O, Google was announced that Wear OS was going to receive a long-awaited and significant update. The question reminded whether existing wearables running Wear OS would be upgradable to the new Wear OS version co-developed by Google and Samsung. And Qualcomm also confirmed that they are working with Google on bringing Wear OS 3.0 to Snapdragon Wear 4100 Plus and 4100 platform. Snapdragon Wear 3100, 4100 Plus and 4100 are capable of supporting Wear OS 3.0. But there is no specific information at this time. Xiaomi is number one in the wrist brand in India for the 15th consecutive quarter with 37.3% market share in quarter 1 2021. A leaker released an image of a 160-watt ultra flash charge brick. A mysterious phone spotted with a big camera sensor was seen in the background of the same image. At the time, the publication did not share anything about the mysterious device. Today, the publication shared a render of a new Infinix phone. It appears that the render belonged to the same handset that was seen along with the 160-watt charger. Starting from the front, the forthcoming Infinix phone features a 3D glass display with a punctual position at the top left corner. The top and the bottom bezels of the phone are quite thin and it has extremely curved edges. Motorola Defy, the first rugged phone made by Bullet Group, the company behind Cat and Land Rover branded rugged phones. A few months ago, the Motorola has signed a partnership with UK-based company to make a Motorola branded rugged smartphones. The Motorola Defy is one of the better looking rugged phones with its camera layout that fuses seamlessly with the cross-hatching design of the toughened polycarbonate back. True, the bezels are huge, that is not uncommon for the rugged phones. Motorola has also added a lanyard to the bottom corner of the phone and an inscription that reads, "Dust Water Drop Proof." This phone will be available in black and green color. The new rugged phone has a 6.5 inch HD Plus screen with a water drop notch and a Gorilla Glass pictures. The only other mid-range phone with coring screen protection solution is Redmi Note 10 Pro 5G. Vivo is gearing up to launch a new Y series smartphone in India. Let's take a look at the Vivo Y12a specification, features and other details. This smartphone will sport a 6.51 inch IPS LCD display. It will have a 720p HD plus display under the hood. The phone will draw power from Qualcomm Snapdragon 439 processor. It will come in a single 3GB RAM variant and a 32GB of internal storage. The company is likely to offer an option to extend its storage via micro SD card. If we talk about battery, it will pack a massive 5000mAh battery. It will come with 10 watt fast charging support. It will have a dual camera setup on the back. There is a 13 megapixel primary camera and a 2 megapixel of secondary sensor. For selfies and video calls, user will get a 8 megapixel front camera on the Y12a. This device will run on Android 11 out of the box. Like most Vivo phones, the device will also run with a layer of FunTouch OS 11 on top of the Android mobile operating system. OnePlus Nord CE 5G is one of the two new smartphones from the brand other than OnePlus Nord N200 5G. OnePlus has started rolling out the second system update for the OnePlus Nord CE 5G hours apart from the first update. Both the software builds bring fixes and improvements for the handset. The first ever system update for the OnePlus Nord CE 5G arrives as Oxygen OS 11.0.2.2. This build bumps up the security patch level to May 2021. Further, it comes with an improvement for screen color accuracy and portrait photography on the selfie camera. It also fixes some known issues. On the other hand, the second system update for the device bears the build number Oxygen OS 11.0.3.3. This update brings improvement for HDR shooting experience and nightscape shooting effect. Lastly, it also optimizes the fluency of 60 frames per second 1080p video recording and fixes certain known issues. Facebook is planning to start rolling out its podcast product next week on June 22nd and eventually adding a feature that will allow listeners to create clips from their favorite shows. Chinese startup Pony.ai has commenced testing of its driverless vehicle on public roads in the US state of California. This is a prelude to full rollout of commercial robo-taxi service in the US planned for 2022. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.